Kose mama.
Hey Rosie, Diana here with another episode of my own recent rotation series. This time I thought I would also do an outdoor edition because the weather is just beautiful and indoors it's a kind of strange lightning, so I just decided to go outdoors. And I also always enjoy the outdoor videos I see from Dan Costello or Calm. And as you might have seen by the trailer of this video, I went to a record store yesterday, and the records I'm featuring here are just the finds, some of the finds I made yesterday. It was kind of interesting. There were kind of like 50 vendors there. For the first time in quite some time, I have not found that much jazz, but a lot of psychedelic and prog stuff, which is kind of welcome because the last pairs tended to be pretty much on the jazz side and there was almost nothing else. And this time the jazz sections were quite small and there were a lot of bargain bins, but with absolutely not interesting stuff at all. And something which kind of bugs me for quite some time, and this time it was so apparent as well, is the amount of vendors that just sell bootlegs or counterfeits. And it really bugs me. And for example, I don't know how many times I came across Alice Coltrane's Journey in Sachin and Danda. There were all these fishy bootlegs, and some vendor was even that quick to label all his bootlegs as second pressings. So you had a sealed, completely mint copy of a Josh Ben record, and it just was labeled as second pressing, which I think is really telling. So yeah, but there are some really interesting finds which I just want to show you. For example, one I was really happy to come across because I have never seen it in the wild, that's the McDonald and Giles record, which was originally released in 1970 over Island Records. This is the 1977 Polytor repress, UK repress. And I think I don't have to say that much about that album. It's a really great psychedelic, jazzy, prog album, I would say. The former King Crimson members, Ian McDonald and Michael Giles, the main artists here. McDonald is playing guitar, piano, organ, sax, flute, clarinet, silver, and is singing here. Michael Giles is playing drums, percussion, including milk bottle, handsaw, lip whistle, and nutbox, and singing. And his brother Peter Giles, who also played bass on In the Wake of Poseidon, is playing bass guitar here. Steve Winwood is playing organ and piano solo on Turn and Green, and Michael Blakesley is playing trombone. Even though this record needs a thorough cleaning, the pressing sounds absolutely amazing. What struck me the most is how much in the foreground the drumming of Michael Giles is. Even though it's King Crimson members, it sounds profoundly different than King Crimson, I would say. It's really jazzy, it's really psyche. You have the prog rock you love from King Crimson. You have some classical instruments here. Sometimes it's even sounding a little bit cheesy, but marvelous sax play. The drum breaks on here are just really impressive. And sometimes it's even a little bit funky. And yeah, it's kind of a wild mix, but I'm really, really happy to finally have this.
Oh,
one is Kolo Semama from Drum Cold Rain. On Impulse, this is the French first press from 1967. The second side, Vigil and Welcome, was recorded in summer 65. The first side, the sidelong track Kolo Semama, was recorded in autumn 1965. Side 2 features a beautiful quartet consisting of John Coltrane on sax, Mac O'Tyner on piano, Jimmy Garrison on bass, and Elvin John on drums. And this first side features John Coltrane on tenor sax, Mac O'Tyner on piano, Jimmy Garrison on bass, Donald Garrett on bass and bass clarinet, Pharoah Sanders on tenor sax, Elvin Jones on drums, Frank Bradda on drums, and Juno Lewis on vocals and percussion. And Juno Lewis also wrote the poem Juno Semama, which is featured here, and is featured in the title track, and it's basically a tribute to his mother, so it's very fitting for Mother's Day today. And yeah, the title track is just an absolutely beautiful piece. Due to the vocals, it's kind of really spiritual. There's this great African vibe, having this astral traveling vibe, and Vigil on the second side is an outstanding outlet of Elvin Jones and John Coltrane together, and Welcome features the beautiful quartet, and it's just another amazing example of their work together. So, to say it in the words of Anthony Complone, this album is just sensational. And yeah, I really love it, and even though it's kind of different to Ascension, which was released in the same time, I really like the more spiritual vibe here, and I think this could easily be a Pharoah Sanders album too, so yeah. So if you like the likes of Thambi or Karma and all the astral traveling stuff of Alice Coltrane, this would be a thing too, I guess. Blind by, and I'm absolutely happy that I went for it. The Savage Rolls in the Plane. Absolutely beautiful cover. This is a Danish psychedelic prog album from 1968. Almost all of them went to a classical music school. So this record has a really interesting mix between psychedelic and prog and jazz and blues and sometimes even some classical elements. Yeah. What is really outstanding here is the kind of exotic and childlike voice of the singer Anisette, which alternates really nicely with male choirs, and yeah, you have this really, really unique voice, and the record itself is kind of unique, I would say. It fits perfectly in the 1960s, 70s psychedelic range. Long before I was born, the first track has this really intense piano riff. I'm Walking Through the Door, the second track is kind of more ethereal. Really interesting is the last song, A Trial in Our Native Town, where the organ was recorded in the church of their capital city, and had this really baroque classical vibe to it, but also intense and really interesting vocalization on it, and it's an astonishing album, and I really hope to include some needle drops for it.
One,
one is Norman Comer's Dance of Magic. His debut as a leader released in 1972 over Copperstone. This is a promo copy. And Norman Comer was a drummer on, for example, Sam Rivers' Use. And he played together a lot with Pharoah Sanders, for example, on Love in Us All and Village of Pharoahs. He's playing drums here. Herbie Hancock is playing piano and Fender Rhodes electric piano. Carlos Garnett is tenor and soprano saxophonist here. Gary Bartz is on alto and soprano sax. Eddie Henderson is on trumpet. Art Webb is on flute. Cecil McBee is on bass. Sandy Clark is on bass. Ned Bettis is playing African percussion and congas here. Tony Wiles is playing African percussion and bellyphone here. Baba Femi is playing African percussion and shakers. Alphonse Mouzon is doing percussion. The UBF singers sing on the title track. Billy Hart is doing percussion and Ayato is doing percussion on some tracks. So not all the artists I listed are featured on every single track, some are just appearing on some of the tracks. This has a really great spiritual vibe to it. It has some heavy African and Latin flavors due to the percussion on here. It is great free jazz, and sometimes it alternates between solo pieces of the instruments, and sometimes you have kind of a big band flavor, but you can clearly recognize every instrument here, and it's really free at some times, and then it's really mellow and relaxed. So yeah, it's a great album. Is a compilation Psych Funk 101 World Psychedelic Funk Classics from the years of 1967 to 1980. This was released over the World Psychedelic Funk Classics label in 2009. They made some other great compilations concerning some more obscure psych from Brazil and other countries. This compilation features some more obscure and not so much known artists from Turkey, Nigeria, Ethiopia, South Korea, Greece, Iran, Germany, Italy, Lebanon, Egypt, Turkey, Russia and France. For example, you will find Mulatto Astatke here with some really interesting vocalization. It covers a great range of tracks. My favorite tracks would be the South Korean track of Kim Sam, The Man Who Must Leave, which I'm going to needle drop, and the group, The Feedback, which you might know because I know that a lot of people have shown this. It's the title song of the LP they made, and Ennio Morricone is playing trumpet here, which is really funny. And yeah, this is the South Korean track, and There's extensive information featured to every track, which is really cool. And if you dig just the psychedelic funk obscure world stuff, this would definitely be your thing, because it mixes beautifully all the interesting psychedelia with some folk influences. For example, the track from Tehran, Iran, is really interesting, and yeah, covers a great range. Thank you. song does not need that much introduction as well, and that's the beautiful Nick Drake, Brighter Later, which was originally released in the 1970s. This is the 2008 reissue over Island Records. This is just a fabulous folk classic, I would say, combining Nick Drake's fragile voice with the beautiful and subtle string acoustic instrumentation. I think there's not that much to say about it, but it's terrific. For a stone in a tin can is worth to the city man who leaves his arm down. Who could have been your friend? A whole long lifetime could have been the end. I could be so true. I would be, I should be through and through. Let us sing for my supper. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. I hope you will all have a sunny day and see you soon. Bye!